One thing that motivates me to do what I do, to wake up every day, is knowing that there are people out there that are less fortunate than I am. I feel like I've been very blessed to have a good life. And you know, one thing that I keep in mind every day when I lace up my shoes or take the court for a game or practice is that, you know, some people can't do what I do. Some people don't have arms, or some people don't have legs, or some people have heart conditions. So, you know, that's what makes me put the extra effort in to be successful and to do this, to do what I do as long as I'm able to, because I know that at the end of the day, there are a lot of people that wish they could do what I'm doing.
Yeah, we obviously need to tone it down a bit. Running around town, spending time like it's counterfeit. Everybody catching hay fever like sinuses. Step in my arena, let me show y'all who the highness is. You might say I could be doing something positive. Humble head down low and broke like promises. Soaking and broken in a joke like comics is. Not enough paper to be paying folks compliments. But when that paper got low, so did my tolerance. And it ain't no truth in the dead without the consequence. Listen, if not for these hood inventions, I'll be just another kid from the block with no intentions. On a dock of that bay, serving a life sentence. Even if I'm going to hell, I'm gonna make an entrance. Yeah, let them know I'm getting cheese like omelets is. But I'm the toast of the town like Thomas
we
is.
All on a journey.
I started playing basketball when I was 7 years old. I started playing in my neighborhood. A couple of older guys, they used to come and teach me how to play. And me and my brother used to be on the playground every day. And from then on, I just started to love the game, and I just started to play. And you know, it just became a hobby of mine. And then now it's a career. I went to two universities. I went to the University of Oregon, and I went to Illinois State University. And I studied political science there at both universities, and I really enjoyed the subject. And I went on, after my college career, I went on to play professionally. I began my career in France. Since then, I've been traveling, playing in various leagues around the world, which has brought me here to Russia, and I'm hoping to make the best of it. Throughout my professional basketball career, I've played in several different places, but each place, each different country has their own unique, has something unique about them that, you know, I really enjoyed about the country. So I really couldn't tell you which country is the best, because I really like all of them and I enjoyed the people and the culture, and that's just, I can't choose one. Playing in the Olympics was a dream come true. That's what everybody dreams about when they're a kid coming up playing basketball or playing in any sport, is playing in the Olympics on the biggest stage. I had a chance to play against some awesome players, against some awesome teams. One of the teams being the United States of America. I really enjoyed that experience. It was one that, you know, I'll cherish for the rest of my life. Playing against guys like LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, Russell Westbrook, Kobe Bryant, and such great players. It was amazing. I really enjoyed it. And just being in the Olympics in general, it's an experience that you'll never forget. Me and my team, we made history as the first African team to qualify for the Olympics, the first African team to win a game in the Olympics. So we were very proud of our accomplishments, and we hope to one day repeat such accomplishments and even get further. After the Olympics experience, it was quite an eventful time in my life. I had a lot of offers, and I had a lot of looks to go play in different places. One of them being in Miami for the Miami Heat. They really took an interest in me. And it was great to be able to come and work out and play with those guys. And I really enjoyed the organization. They have a great organization with Coach Eric Spoelstra and great coaching staff. And, you know, I really enjoyed that experience also. And hopefully that's not the last time they see me. From my impression of LeBron is, you know, he's a very good guy. He's very charismatic, has a lot of character. And, you know, he's a real funny guy. He's always trying to make people laugh. And, you know, I had a great time down there in South Beach. Also had, along with Miami, I also had a workout with the San Antonio Spurs. And, you know, I went down there to San Antonio and I did my best to try to impress the coaching staff. And I did a good job, and some of the guys, one of my good friends is Ime Udoka, who's now an assistant coach for the San Antonio Spurs. And, you know, he really showed me the ropes, and he really, you know, guided me when I went down there, and, you know, I really look up to him, and it was a good experience. Going into the Olympic qualifiers in Venezuela, I didn't know what to expect. I knew that there would be good teams, but I didn't know how good the teams would be. One of the teams that pleasantly surprised me was Russia. Russia had a very good national team, and with guys like Alexei Sved and Sasha Khan and Andrei Kirilenko, all of these guys really surprised me. And you know, we played a good game. It was a very good game down there, and you know, unfortunately for us, Russia was the victors. But, you know, I was really surprised at the level of competition and the level of talent that Russia had, and I've also seen it since I've been here in Russia. I've played one game with this team, Spartak Primorye, and after the game, I feel very good about this team. I feel very good about where we're headed. I think this team has a lot of potential, and, you know, the guys have been very friendly. They've welcomed me with open arms, and that's something that, you know, you as a player, as a foreign player, you really respect, you know, the personalities of the team. And, you know, sometimes they teach me Russian every day. I tell them to teach me some Russian every day so I know something, so I learn something new. So it's been very good, and, you know, things look very promising for Spartak Primorye. I chose to wear the number 23 because I think there was one time during the season, I can't remember which one it was, I had the number 23 and I really did perform well. And so from that day on, I just always wanted to wear number 23 because that's when I played the best. 23 is also a special number because it's connected to Michael Jordan when he was playing for the Chicago Bulls. You know, 23 symbolizes greatness as far as basketball is concerned. Not quite Michael Jordan, but, you know, I strive for greatness every day, and that's something that number 23 symbolizes to me. It's my first time in Russia, and I have to say I am pleasantly surprised. Other than the fact that it is very, very cold, I have really enjoyed my time here thus far, and you know, the people are very nice, and I'm really appreciating the culture here. And, you know, like I said, my teammates have been very friendly and have welcomed me, and everything seems to be going good. It's just very, 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 very cold. I have a lot of hobbies. Some of my hobbies include, I like to play video games. All guys like to play video games. Another one of my hobbies is I like to write. I like write things such as poems and letters and things like that. And I also like to sing on my free time. Probably not a good singer. I think I am, but who knows? I don't know, maybe I'm not. But yeah, so those are some of my hobbies besides basketball. My name is Chamberlain, and my father is who named me Chamberlain because in the Nigerian culture, it's very important to have a boy. I have two older sisters, and my parents hadn't had a boy yet. There was a British naval, his name was Chamberlain, and he had a quote that said, "I owe the world nothing more." And when I was predicted to be a girl coming out of the womb, But when I was a boy, my dad was so rejoiceful that I was a boy that he named me Chamberlain, with the quote in mind, I owe the world nothing more, because that is how he felt at the time, is that he owed the world nothing more since he had his son. Hey, this is Champ Oguchi, number 23, and you can follow Spartak Primorty on Twitter, Instagram, and the website at Spartak Basket. Or you can also follow me, Champ Oguchi, on my Twitter at Champ Oguchi.